Hello, happy Friday, viewers. I hope you all got your beers ready. Welcome to another weekly show with myself, Tiberius Stargazer, my good, good friend, General Stargazer, who's in comms with me. Say hello, General.
Hello, General.
Not literally, but that will do. And of course, we also have my Commander-in-Chief, Mr. Bossman himself, leader of our hearts, Nashh Kadavr. Say hi, Nashh.
Hi, Nashh.
I'm just getting trolled today with the highs.
That was one instruction.
Well, you know, I've got to talk you up a little bit, haven't I? If I want to earn those brownie points for things, I've got to be doing that, haven't I?
You're after a pay rise again or something.
Maybe there's still more skins out there that I need to buy. You know, there's like a 30 billion Nick skin that I've got my eyes on at the moment. So
yeah, we'll see what we can do.
So I hope you've all got your beers set up. We've got a packed show for you tonight. We're going to be going through this week's meetups that are happening. And there's a lot of them this week. There's a lot of them. We'll also be talking a bit about some of the upcoming meets that will be happening next month, both in Antwerp and Germany. We will then also go through some of the schedule for this week's Event TV. And once we have done that, I'll also be showing off some player-created videos that are my pick of the week. And we then go on to some EVE Online news before we then switch over onto some EVE Valkyrie news, including a video specially made for tonight by General himself. And once we finish that off, we'll wrap up the show, give a few shout-outs, and cut to a couple of picked videos for this week as well. So first of all, I'd like to put in a little plug for a project that we're currently promoting. It is the EVNT Creator Studio. It's run by Tamba, who was a member of one of the original CSMs 2 and 3, and it's designed around to be used at all by artists to render ship models in methods which will allow them to import them into their own bits of work. So check out this video, and we will link the fundraiser that we have going for that one in the Twitch stream. So And so there we go. Check that out. We are about halfway through for the goal for that one. So if you are really into your EVE spaceships, go check out the link, especially if you use such a tool for your own creations. It's a fantastic, fantastic tool. I've used it on occasion, and you know, great artists that use it include Rix Javix and Niden, who produce fantastic bits of work. So please, please, if you can spare any funding for that, go ahead and let's make this project happen. So we'll be moving on next to some of the meets that are coming up. And holy cow, there's quite some big meets, because one of the biggest US meets has kicked off this weekend. And that is if I can find my link to it, might be a good start. Eve Northeast. And Eve Northeast is in its third year, I believe.
Yeah, but it's a new venue, I believe, this year.
That's right. That's right, it is. So let's just have a quick look at... see if this in-game browser is actually still working. It used to be in New England. Then it had to move to Pennsylvania. So, there we go. So here's our meets for the week.
Yeah, the previous host, I believe, sold the property that he was on.
That's right. So that's kicking off. It started last night. I know there was plenty of tweets from people out there that were heading their way out. I'm really interested to see how this one goes. And I'll be looking forward to seeing some of the news that comes out from there once that has finished up. There is an article on the Eventy website as well. It's on the archive for last month. There's some pictures from last year's, and it looks like a fantastic, fantastic event. Next up, we have Eve Montreal round two. I don't know anything about this event because it was actually put up quite recently. Unsurprisingly, it's at Montreal, Canada. It's at their usual place, the Nexus Smart Bar, and it's a growing event. They keep getting regular people to that one. So if you're in that area of the world, please do check out that meet. It should be a pretty good one. And the Nexus Smart Bar is a fantastic looking venue. Very, very hip and techno. I really, really like it. And then we have another new event which has appeared in the last couple of weeks. The first EVE 303 pub crawl, and this is in Denver. Pub crawl schedule kicks off at 1800 at Illegal Pete's, which is on 16th Street, 101 Denver. So go check that one out. Join up with your EVE buddies there. And last but not least, we have the Houston Monthly Meet. These guys meet every single meet. It's at the King's Head Pub, and it looks like a fantastic sort of traditional old schooly type pub. Go check that out. You can find out more about these meets and venues on evemeet.net. And if you log in using the single sign-on for your EVE account, you can also set up notifications so it will tell you when the next meets are coming up, or even create your own. And if you do create your own, let me know at Tiberius Stargaz, and I'll be quite happy to put it on the website. And I think that's everything for our EVE meet bits. We then have, of course, a couple of very big, well, one big meet coming up next month, which is especially for all you German guys that may be living out down in Dusseldorf. And let's see if this still works, because they haven't removed it from the browser yet. Hey, oh, look, okay. Nashh.
You're right, beta yep. Testing a feature that's going to be removed. It's
pretty cool. I know, right? Look at the EVNT logo in there. It's weird. There, that's not working. Is it working? It's not working.
Beauts, mate.
Nah, beautiful. So professional, aren't we? Anyway, so we have going on in Dusseldorf next month. Tickets have just become available for it. G Fleet Camp. It is their second event. They held their first one last year. They're holding it at what can only be described as a fantastic looking building, the Hans Peter Zimmer Foundation premises, which is this massive old industrial warehousey type place, very fitting for an EVE venue. They have spaces for 200 people. The tickets have been out for 3 weeks, and they've already sold over 100 of them. All the early birds and the super early bird tickets have already gone, and for €89 you can get yourself a standard ticket, and that includes 3 hot meals, 5 drinks, finger food and nibbles throughout the event, a one-of-a-kind G-Fleet t-shirt made specially for the event, and some additional super secret things. And it didn't matter how much I twisted Tyrone's arm, one of the organizers, he just wouldn't tell me what these super secret things are. But they should be good, and they're definitely going to be worth it. They'll be showcasing Eve Valkyrie as well, and they will be having a 1v1 frigate tournament. So if you are in Germany, go check that out. Make sure that you get your tickets in early because they are going super quick. More information can be found on eve-nt.uk. It's on our front page. Go check that out.
And do you want to go, Tibbs? We should go, man.
Ah, I wish I could, man. You know that.
I'm thinking about it.
Oh, yeah. There you go.
Yeah.
Got to get in quick because those tickets are going super fast.
I know. See, I'm debating. The wife wants to take me to Liverpool next weekend, and I'm debating on whether we should cancel that and go to Germany instead.
Just a minor alteration, then.
Just a slight deviation.
Just going to Liverpool via Germany.
Yeah.
But then again, I also think Germany is like way more sellable than Liverpool, maybe. I'm sorry, Liverpool. I'm just annoyed every single Liverpool person,
wow.
But I'll be honest, I'd rather be going to Germany. So if I get poop from my letterbox, I know what's happened. But yeah, I'd love to go to that because it looks like a fantastic, fantastic event. They've got four rooms there as well, a bar, everything. You know, it looks like it's going to be a great, great event. Because last year they had room for 100 people and they were kind of only expecting, you know, maybe 40 or 50. They nearly maxed out the venue. So they were really happy with that. There's some pictures of that event from last year as well on the website too. And last but not least, because Jorg, bless him, will probably castrate me if I did not shout out his meet that's coming up on July 20th. That's in Antwerp. And it is at the, what is this place? Beer Central, which is Antwerp city centre. And it's only a quick walk away from Antwerp Central Station, where CCP Red Dawn will also be making an appearance. There are no tickets for this. It's basic pub meet. And you can go and check out the EVNT website. There's some information on there on how to find out some more information of the event and also make sure that you register your interest on the Eventbrite page as well.
I'd just like to say that if you're going to a venue that's called Beer Central, you know you're going to have a good time.
Well, yeah, and it's in Belgium as well. So, you know, the place where the best beers come from. So, and apparently they have somewhere on the region of 40 beers on draft and 200 beers bottled.
Okay, fuck Germany. We're not going to Germany. We're going to Belgium.
That's it. Fantastic stuff. And I think that's all the general meet news that we got for this week. So without further ado, we're all going to take a quick break for a couple of minutes. In the meantime, I'm going to show you a video one of my favorite videos, to be quite honest. It's a great piece of propaganda from the masters of propaganda themselves, Test Alliance. It was their spring 2015 videos because they release a video every so often just to show things off. And this is Test Alliance Fly.
You and I. Take you
And there we go, we're back. And there we go. And just in time, actually, because we just went live again. So that was fantastic. Wow. Good timing. I've still got half a beer because I have gone for the extra size beers. I have gone for the extra size beers from Italy to try and drown my sorrows from this morning's referendum.
Make the most of it.
I was going
to
say that.
Exactly. I'm trying to make the most of it. Exactly. Because, this stuff's going to get expensive if they decide to put tariffs on them. Fun.
I've joined you in the European beers. I'm actually drinking some Barcelona beers, some Estrella Dams. That's what I've got.
Estrella Dams. Well, I've got the good old Italian classic Peroni.
Nice.
Guinness, which for the sake of things, in probably 2 years' time, it will be an international
Well, yeah. We'll see. Maybe the Scottish are saying they're going to go for an independence referendum. Maybe the Northern Islands will go, well, no, screw this. We're going to rejoin back up the rest of Ireland. Never know. It could happen.
Enough of real life.
But it's funny how Eve politics and real world politics. Actually,
the link there was beer.
I'm trying to make fantasy.
Let's stay in fantasy land, man.
But if we go with Eve politics.
New Eden is much better than Earth. Let's stay here.
But if we go with Eve politics, generally the guy with the biggest blob wins. And the UK decide to leave the big blob. So,
meh. Suckers.
Suckers. Yeah. So, moving on to more interesting things, we have this weekend's schedule for EVE NT TV up on screen now. Of course, we're Stargazing with Stargazers, which you're watching now, hopefully, and not falling asleep. Then we have Reloaded by, which is another EVE Online bit. You know, what does Reloaded actually do in this, Nashh? Tell me. Does he know?
As far as I'm aware, at least, it's a bit of solo and roaming PvP. But I think I should say I don't think he's actually on tonight because he's just recently moved.
He just linked a picture of his new office, which is basically his PC and screen on the floor next to his bed. Which...
On a box.
That's all you need, man. He can play Eve. He'll be fine.
Ah, I love it. And then after that, we have the Master of Fitting, Sutonia, doing his fitting show. Do we know what Sutonia is doing for the subject of his fitting show today?
I'm not sure specifically what he's planning, but having seen his previous shows, he basically picks a ship, goes out for a little bit, kills some stuff, and then ends up discussing specific fits and answering questions about... what works, what doesn't work, people's opinions, and telling them their shit. So,
yeah. I like that. That sounds like a great idea. Why don't you fit this to it? No, you shit.
Yep.
Then we have Plugging Eye for a bit of high octane Valkyrie action. Always good to get a 4-hour only Valkyrie slot for this evening. And then we finish off this evening with Frigate Friday Cardinal Sin, who will be taking out some frigates on a solo roam, try and see what trouble he can get himself into, and hopefully blow up more ships than he gets blown up. And then we move on to Saturday, where we have the Alliance Tournament training with Bayart J. Then...
If he can sort out his computer.
Yeah,
he did. Did you see his show last week? He basically, what he does is, I believe it's Test Alliance, correct me if I'm wrong. Test Alliance do like an open training session kind of thing. And they basically invite anybody to come and train in their Alliance tournament practices. Now, obviously, nobody has specific details about the Alliance tournament, but they go by a bastardized version of last year's rules. And rather than trying to find secret specific teams to go and do secret combat with, they basically make it a public event. Bay basically jumps in and checks what people are bringing and explains what they're doing, how they're doing it, and possibly why they're doing it, and speculating. Other than his internet being super shit, the show is definitely very interesting. And you'll see some good contenders for the Alliance tournament coming up.
So basically, if you want a sneak peek on what those teams are working on for the Alliance tournament, this is the show you want to be watching. Really. Just to see what the meta might be panning out. Because, particularly maybe today, I think they must have been out by now.
Falcon sets at some point today. Yes.
Yep, some point today, if they're not already out, the Alliance tournament rules should finally be out, which we will be reporting on as soon as we get hold of them, and they'll be available on the EVT website if you would rather visit us, which would be very much appreciated, rather than the dev blogs, and at my one of my staff will be writing that up early at some point next week. Then on the Sunday, it's a busy day on Sunday as well, we got the 07 show, which kicks off at 8 p.m. We will be hosting that from the CCP Twitch stream. Then followed straight after that, we'll have Chocolate Rain doing show. She's back from her holiday and vacations, and she'll be doing show for that evening. And then we'll have Biohazard doing Biohazard as Valkyrie for the evening. He's just got his kit, if I've read Twitch right. Yes, his Oculus landed just yesterday.
Yeah. So he's been fighting for this thing for so long.
Oh.
Man, I'm happy for him, man.
Managed to find a webpage that actually had it in stock for like 10 minutes.
Wow.
And he sent the link and it was like, yep, I'm getting that. I don't know.
Yeah.
Is it real? And then he ordered it and sure enough, it arrived.
Lucky.
Yeah, he's been so jealous of General. As soon as General joined our Slack, he's been like crying in secret, you know, every day, the fact that he didn't have one. He's super happy.
Have you guys seen that that Twitter feed? Is Half-Life 3 out yet? Like, literally, every day it goes, and is Half-Life 3 out yet? No. Like, every single day. That is literally the entire Twitter feed. It has tens of thousands of followers on it. Go figure that one out, right? But for that entire time, while Biohazard was waiting for that, it was like, literally, has my Oculus arrived yet? No. Has my Oculus arrived yet? No. Has my Oculus arrived yet? No. And then it happened. It's like, yes, it's here. Picture, wow. Photos. Yes. So straight on there. So
yeah, very, very cool. Just a quick one while you're on the Sunday. I think, I don't know what you guys are like, but I absolutely fucking love the 07 show. It's my favorite part of the month. So I'm very much looking forward to it. The one thing that annoys me about it is the fact that there are so many people watching it now, and it's so popular that the actual Twitch chat is unreadable. Like, you can't follow what the fuck anybody is saying. So the reason why we're hosting it is, one, because with a bit of luck, CCP will be hosting R2 shows immediately after it, which is great. But also, our Twitch chat is a little bit more quiet. So if you still want to discuss in Twitch chat what's actually happening on the 07 show and follow what is actually being said in chat, our chat will be a little bit more quiet. So maybe worth considering.
Fantastic stuff. And that wraps up pretty much this weekend's shows. Be sure to tune in, check them out. We'll be kicking off next week. Same again, we'll have General Stargazer running his two Valkyrie shows. 6 hours of Valkyrie. Man, you're a machine. I don't know how you do it.
I love it.
And we got a little highlight from one of your streams later on today, later on in the show, when we talk a bit more about Valkyrie. So I've had a little quick sneak peek of it. I haven't watched the entire thing, so I'm really looking forward to that one. And then we have, again, Biohazard presenting some EVE Online on the Wednesday evening with Lysis, who's another well-known EVE Online Twitch streamer. Then we'll have the Jeff Raider show on Thursday. We normally give away some goods with the Jeff Raider show, do we not, Nash?
Yes, we do. Yeah. Quick shout out for Lysis. He's been doing really well. I don't know whether you've seen his Twitter feed. He's been doing some amazing stuff with his succubus. He's got like 40 kill marks on it or some shit.
You're kidding me.
Yeah, he's an absolute machine. But to be fair, like, it's like, I'm pretty sure it's like Officer Fit or some crap. Like,
so basically, when it's going to die, it's going to die spectacular.
Oh, yeah. I think he's looking to do a T1 frigate show soon, which, if I'm not mistaken, is going to be costing him about 500 mil, which will be interesting. But yes, I mean, for any show that we do on the EVENT stream, we would do gifts. Any streamer that wants anything can just do any giveaways they like, pretty much, which are funded by EVENT. But Jeff Rader is certainly the pioneer in this and generally gives away... Wow, anything. EVENT codes, EVBET codes, pirate rookie ships, Plex. I mean, he's given away all sorts of stuff so far.
He has given away a lot of stuff. Straight after that, we have the return of the EVE history with Hendrik Teledar, who will be going over some of the key moments of EVE Online player lore, player history. It's a great series if you really want to understand where a lot of the alliances in the game have come from, a bit more about their history, a bit about the larger events that have shaped the EVE universe as we know it today. And then, of course, we get back onto Friday, but I see you haven't put Stargazing with the Stargazers on the Friday start of it because you are bad.
I am bad.
But thankfully, that is 1 week ahead of now. We'll be talking about next weekend stuff next weekend. So we will be moving on to EVE Online news. But first, I'm going to be showing our next video, which is, again, by our good friend Reloaded, who will be streaming a little bit later on tonight, the Zekel Guide to the Bar Guest.
Yeah, love this guy.
Or the Pancake.
Let's go.
Because it's all about balanced legions. Let's check this one out.
Let's go.
Don't lose your way.
The Barghest, or the Pancake, is a faction battleship made by the Balanced Legion. Seriously, their entire shipline is fucking ridiculous. Fortunately, CCP knows how to balance ships well, and recently the Barghest got changed to keep it in line with its smaller brothers the Orthurus and Gamma. The Barghest is in a dressier, pancaked, with rapid headers, with a Mordus Legion badge on it. The Barghest is probably one of the strongest subcaps in the game right now, but it does have a few enemies that you don't want to meet. The balance module known as the Warp Disruption Field Generator and Carriers, avoid these at all costs and everything will be alright. The Barghest is a fast tier battleship and will keep up with most cruiser and battle cruisers, but you will lose a race from a mech, so don't try. The Barghest excels at using rapid heavies. Do not use the other battleship missile weapons, they are shit. Only use rapid heavies also. T3Ds are your greatest enemy, because you cannot apply your damage to them. So try to avoid them. If you cannot, just use your no-scope module and peace out, or use your heavy newts to give them a restraining order. The Barghest is also the best no-scoping ship in the game, because of its point bonus. Cue the no-scoping montage. The Barghest can be both shield or armor tanked. Because of its dank slot layout, you can have more utility and less damage, or less damage or more utility. Entirely your choice. Here is how you flavor your pancake. You fit rapid heavies, dual heavy notes. For the mids I go triple prop. For dank no scopes and hip getaways, point scram for obvious reasons, and a cap booster. For the low slots, I fit a nano, reactive armor hardener, dual BCU. AAR and damage control. For Riggs I use dual ACR for fitting room and a rigger for application, but do whatever that floats your camel. Now you know how to use the Barghest. Now go out there and roleplay as Big Micah and show people battleship supremacy.
role players bit wanker. What the fuck?
You gotta love this one. I mean, it's
great. Oh, fun.
I do. This is how you flavour your pancake. So, before we get into Eve news, let's take care of the important thing, which is obviously the beers. Cheers, boys.
Cheers.
Okay, moving on. So let's talk a little bit about Eve updates on the test server. There's not been many updates on the test server this week. Normally we get quite a few because we're getting very, very close to the next point update, which I think is coming when, Nash? Next weekend? Next week?
Pass.
Soon.
Soon.
Yep. You're going to make me Google this, aren't you?
Man, I'm starting to get paranoid about what I can and can't say. Do you know what I mean? I'm going to be super careful and just not say anything.
That's all right. There's only you, me, and like the 11 people watching this stream, and the couple of hundred people that might watch the video afterwards. You know, you'll be fine. 28th of June. June? Yes.
4 days from now.
Four days from now, indeed. So that's ever approaching faster and faster, and you can find out all the info about EVE Online's updates on updates.eveonline.com, which is the best way to have a look at it. We've got, obviously, the Shadow of the Serpent event kicking off. Great. We showed a little bit about that last week with some of the things. I do notice now, when I'm in station here now, that there's this scope network is actually showing what they will and will not be rewarded for. But I'm wondering if they added in the ability to re-roll events yet. No. Okay. Oh, but there is a mining thing on here. Perfect. I can get my orts and go mining. Superb. Although they've changed all the look of this. They've just got like these little funny icons for the rewards. What are these? This used to be like a Demios and stuff. Now it's like a weird token?
I have seen some of the awards coming out. And again, out of my own safety concerns, I won't say anything. But I'm excited, man.
But do you know what this
I'm tempted to be doing this shit. I'm actually tempted to be doing this stuff.
I know a lot of it is probably going to be based around the new capitals which are coming out, because the... That processor drops out the capitals. We discussed a bit more about that last week. You can find that on my YouTube. If you go to Tiberius Stargazer on YouTube, you'll find that video. So we covered a little bit about what goes into those new capital ships there. But these look like a whole bunch of new events. Serpentis guards have been a thorn in our side for too long. We'd like to deal with them. Killed 20 guards. Okay. Reward of resistant destruction Serpentis shipyards. Cool. Do some mining. Fantastic. That's a timed event by the looks of it. Yeah, expires in 1 day. And disrupt the signal. But these events seem to sort of randomize themselves, don't they?
Yeah, I imagine they probably will. They change on a daily basis.
They do change, but they're also specifically catered for what you do on that character specifically.
Oh, are they really?
Yeah, so if you are more the ratting kind of guy, you would be more likely to get those types of missions. If you're more the mining kind of guy, that is the kind of missions that you would get. So it is really specific to your own personal playstyle, which is pretty cool.
That's actually really good. Because there's no indication of that being something that was implemented. And if that is being implemented, that is really good. I guess they go from the stats based on how people play, because you know those websites that collect the annual stats for each character and things? I wonder if it's based on that.
That information is constantly stored and you're only actually viewing it on those websites, so the game can make a decision based on the stats that it's reading, I'm guessing.
I'm just copying some ships over because I realise just flying around in some crappy people might not be the very interesting. Let's take an Abaddon out. Let's just fly an Abaddon around, see what we've got there.
Abaddon!
Have you played Gunjack?
Hello, world second.
What do you mean, world second? Eh?
There's a leaderboard on it. And on the world, I'm second.
Get out of town. Are you serious? I don't believe you. Oh, apparently this character doesn't have the skills yet that I've trained on the main server, so,
Flash copy skills.
Yep, that's going to be the next one. So I'm kind of keen on this, but one of the things they are doing before this event comes out is that they're removing the 10k SP Thrill of a Hunt bonus that you used to get. Which... I don't know. You know what people... I'm fine with... I don't know. I don't know if I'm fine with it. I kind of got used to it. Although...
Well, you've just got a different set of dailies, basically, now.
That is true. But SP, man.
Yeah, but you've gone from having... You had one thing to do. Now you have the option of four different things to do. Okay, granted, it was pretty easy. You know, you just had to literally undock and warp somewhere, and you would pretty much get your 10k SP. But at least you have a variety, and it's kind of thematic now as well.
Yeah, which I think was one of the original criticisms of the 10k SP, wasn't it? It was just it was like undock, blap rat, dock back up. That's it. Finished. And that wasn't very interesting to a lot of people. I'm going to go to a combat area, see if I can't get blown up while we're talking.
Is that an unskinned Abaddon, really?
Oh, fine. What do you want? Imperial armaments or Blood Raiders?
IGC. IGC, man. Oh, sorry, you don't have that.
Well, I don't have it on this yet. And it's not an apocalypse, which we will be having one of those.
Yeah, he's just actually revealed what next year's skin's going to be.
Ah, we did already.
It's the apocalypse. I'm flying the Baden, you numpty, not an apocalypse.
No, after the apocalypse, you spoon.
Oh, right, fine. Okay, fair enough. But there we go. That's the Imperial Armament skin, which is quite nice. Not many people have those. You only got those when you went to FanFest. Which I did. Oh my god, all these Fortisars. Right, anything to blap. There is a fiend here.
It's a...
And he's hick bubbled me.
Wow. Do you actually have crystals?
I
see guns. I don't see crystals.
I have crystals. We're all good. Fuck it, I'm not going to track him for shit, but I'm going to, like, hit him anyway.
Do the rainbow lasers.
Do the rainbow lasers, he says. Oh my god, how long does it take for this thing to lock anything? Yeah, look at that. Oh no, I am hitting him slightly.
Are you complaining about lock time when you didn't activate a sensor booster as well?
Oh, behave. Anywho...
Moving on
while this fiend, this Alliance tournament ship, blaps me because it's ridiculous. Look at this thing! I can't even hit it! Never mind. I'm even using multi-frequency. Oh, the droids, yes! He's, let's see what these hammerheads do to him. He's boosting. Anyway. While my drones go and do their thing, we'll move on to the next subject. So Citadel Expansion Iteration 2, that's coming out with a few more bits of functionality to the Citadels, including redeeming, direct trade, and character customization in Citadels, as well as the ability to set Citadels as an autopilot waypoint. Hurrah! At last. No contracts yet, though. No contracts yet? Is that right, Nash?
Pass again.
Oh, my God.
You ask him again, really?
That's going to be my standard answer.
I can neither confirm nor deny.
Oh my god.
How tanky. Are you seriously concentrating on trying to kill a fiend?
No, I'm not. Yes, I am.
I realise you'll be here till like next Tuesday.
Yeah, that is probably true. Anyway, moving on to the next one. Just has. He's in Volta as well. Never mind.
Get good.
Get, I know, right? it's not like I'm an indecee or any shit like that, you know what I mean? So some additions to the tactical overlay. We've already covered like the new docking and undocking transition to Death and Back and some of the visual updates and some Stargate visual updates. I haven't seen those yet. That's quite interesting. I'm going to die now, so I'm going to concentrate on that. There we go.
Did you say you're going to concentrate on dying?
Well, yeah, I wanted to get my foot out.
It's important.
It's important.
You got to witness the moment. It's always... you know, makes you a stronger person.
There you go, Potty. Woo! Good thing it's only on the Tessa, right?
What was in the
You can
plot?
Tell I'm a man. Nothing. you can tell I'm a man. I can't multitask for shit. So we got some tactical overlay bits and pieces coming along, which includes what we showed last week, which was some vector graphics, which are pretty awesome, actually. So they show where the ship trajectory is. And then what else have we got? And a sinusophil range when you hover over it, so you can see where your sinus lit. That's quite cool. Ship orbits, fighter orbits. So all good stuff. I really, really like the tactical overlay. Let's undock something. And have a look at the tactical overlay, but I really like what they've done with the tactical overlay so far. Like originally, oh hello, I'm in Saarinen. Ah,
can't wonder why that could be.
That's where my pod was, clone pod. Let's have a look. So tactical overlay is there. Check that out. That's pretty awesome stuff. You can see how, maybe if you can see it, but at the front of this Phoenix is a little arrow which shows the direction that it's travelling in. So, that's pretty good stuff. I really like this tactical overlay. They've done some really interesting things with it. For example, distances and ranges and things are no longer just like where you can see a single stick with a ball underneath it to show where it is in relation to you. That never really gave you any range information. Now you get like a curved line.
It's cool stuff. Curvy. It looks pretty.
It's all curvy. It does look very pretty.
It's a lot easier to interpret like distances from things now. Because when you had like a real, because it kind of the rotation kind of changes as things approach you, so you can really kind of separate things as they're coming towards you, rather than kind of having a, as you correctly say, a cluster of white sticks, so you kind of get blinded by your own overlay.
Mm-hmm.
So it does look really sweet now.
It does look pretty good. And I have noticed in a couple of fights I've been in that even though you kind of worry that all of this might be a bit overly cluttered and might, you know, show might clutter up the screen to the point where you can't see anything, I've been in quite a large fight recently, but it didn't detract from the fight at all. The tactical overlay is just subtle enough where it doesn't just overwhelm you with information. If you want to find the information, you just look for it and it's there, but otherwise it doesn't sort of interfere with the overall visual look of the game at all. So I find that I have it on a lot more than what I used to. That's pretty good. Looking forward to that. And then, of course, the faction capital ships are also coming up. We talked a bit about those last week. Legalized combat boosters.
Yes. Legal drugs, man. Legal drugs. It's the future.
Previously, I don't know, man. I'm going to hold to my conservative values and say I'm not entirely sure how I feel about that.
Drugs are...
Drugs are bad, okay?
Drugs are bad for...
drugs. I'm a little bit annoyed by it, but hey.
I mean, because drifter drugs were legal, weren't they?
Yeah.
Like you could get them and move them around, and they gave you the same bonuses as regular drugs, but with none of the drawbacks.
But I say I'm a little bit annoyed, but it was like you're making the argument of people using the limited amount of people using drugs in high sec.
Yeah.
It's just there wasn't a huge amount of people doing it anyway, so I don't think that it's going to have a real massive impact. It's just one less thing to worry about now.
That's true, but that one less thing to worry about had an interesting element of gameplay, which was the smuggling of the drugs into trade centres.
Yeah, not to mention the old implants that had the side benefit of giving you smuggling bonuses.
Yeah, exactly. Which don't work anymore, do they?
No, because... yeah, reasons.
Because reasons. But look, where are the boosters gone? So, there you go. There's the Drifter ones. How do you get Drifter drugs? I mean, I know you get them from, like, the Project Destiny Discovery thing.
Yeah, so you get... There's, I think, off the top of my head, there's 5 overall, and you get 3 from Project Discovery. You get all 5 from doing the Hive sites. When you get to the Pickup Sticks room, which is the room after the Hive room, the big circular disc that everyone's kind of seen as part of the Drifters, after that is another room that has a broken-apart Jove Stargate in. Apparently.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I know.
There's a container in that room, and you get them from that room, basically.
And then you also get them from Project Discovery.
It's just another reward for completing the site, basically.
Then we got some pirate implants. We had a look at those again last week. Bulk fitting, had a look at those 2 weeks ago. Serpenta skins. This is my favourite.
You love your skins, man.
I love Serpentis skins. The only thing is, I've got to work out which ones are going to be like limited run. That once you do the event, that's it. You're not going to get any more of them because those are the ones I will be buying. So if you buy these skins and you would like to set offload them to someone to tweet, feel free to contact me. I will happily relieve them of you, and then immediately go to Nashh and beg for more money to buy them with. and then there's some new player experience improvements. What's this? Do you know about this, Nashh? What are these new player experience improvements are?
I can't confirm or deny any knowledge.
Oh my god!
Whatever you're talking about.
Look, what is literally the point of me having you on this show?
I just probably nothing.
Beer. I would say
I
it's like
beer and I sit here and listen to you. And
I guarantee
well, we guaranteed at least one explosion, so that's fine. That's pretty good. But in an effort to improve the flow of new player experience for rookie pilots, a number of changes will be made to notifications and information displayed in-game. Opportunity guidance will be improved to include clear instructions, better flow, improved sense of progress, and meaningful context to mechanical tasks. An opportunity path will also be suggested to strengthen the sense of progression. Combat that forms part of opportunities will also be made more dynamic in a series of UI improvements that will be implemented to give deeper clarification for a number of in-game activities. That could be a good point in time to maybe, for someone out there, maybe to do a rookie tutorial. We always need people to do those. I tried to do one of those last time and I kind of fizzled out after 3 episodes. But
don't forget as well that if you do record any footage and you know you're not comfortable with putting it together yourself, you can always record the footage, put together a script and send it to CCP now and they will make the video for you.
Yes, that is one thing that they've recently asked for, which is player videos to help them buff out their in-game bits and pieces.
Indeed.
Because they moved all the Flight Academy stuff in-game.
Yep.
At some point. Which
is a really nice feature.
But they didn't tell anybody about it.
It came up on an 07 show.
Yeah, an 07 show, which, okay, 2,000, 3,000 people watched. But, you know, it's like your rookie player, when they log in and look at that, they don't know that's there.
It's the wonderful new discoveries of EVE Online again.
Exactly. So I'm hoping these UI improvements will also include links to these Flight Academy videos as well, because that would be pretty cool. What else do we have on evening? So that's the rough and ready of it, of the patch that's coming out on June the 28th. It's 118.6. We're not naming patches anymore. Yeah, exactly.
We'll just have players kind of unofficially name them. They end up not, to be fair, they normally end up named like that. It's like the patch that gave you, like, Citadel's patch, for example.
Yes.
I have noticed that people have just started to adopt it when they have numerical numbers for patch releases.
So we've already covered that. CCP is a big fan. Call for player video content. There is a dev blog about that. I am going to link it in the channel, Twitch channel now. I will put it in the show notes on YouTube. If I can find my Twitch channel, might also help. There we go. So check that out. If you've got something that you want to contribute to CCP's video content, feel free to go ahead and do it. Especially the Flight Academy stuff. We love helping our newbies out, so make sure that if you have something, you can contribute for that. I'm definitely going to try and have a hand at going that as well. So we'll see. Shadow Suspense event, that's all started kicking off, which should be good. And we kind of already discussed that already. It will have a set of events which you'll be able to run. You can see them on screen already. Which will allow you to earn special rewards. Don't know what these is the beer getting to me already?
Those things. Yes. The shinies.
The shinies. We all like shinies. Nobody more than me likes shinies. And then last but not least, we got the in-game browser, which I'm kind of sad about going, but it does make a lot of sense from the EVE management point of view.
Sad times, man.
Yeah. Well, the only thing I'm like interested in is how is it when I'm going to be linking dank memes in local? Are people going to be able to click and see them, you know?
Yep. Dude, man, that's like 50% of my EVE right there.
You know what it's going to be? More ASCII art.
Yeah, that's what it's going to be.
Oh, please. Man. That's so 1990s. Come on.
So CCP have mentioned in their dev blog that you can use an overlay called Overwolf, which I don't know anything about, but it's TeamSpeak.
Yeah.
And I know that I'm not going to be using TeamSpeak that much.
See, I'm 50-50 on TeamSpeak and Mumble.
Yeah, I mean, for me, I'm going to be leaving. I use TeamSpeak every now and again, but mostly it's going to be Mumble. So, I would like CCP to turn around and say at some point that they'll probably support another overlay of some description. But they do say in the text, to be clear, CCP does not sufficiently support or endorse overlays.
Yeah. So I know there's a couple of boys that are working hard on trying to get something to work. I've listened to a couple of conversations and it sounds very technical, which certainly isn't my strong point. I've pretty much smiled and nodded and went, this sounds really good. And that's pretty much where I had to leave it at. But I think there will be solutions. And if it's not done by CCP, it will be done by a player, most likely.
Mm-mm-mm.
Or players. People will find a way to link them dank memes.
Like dank memes. Yeah, I mean, if I load up my notes here.
I suppose a lot of gambling sites as well would be affected by it, aren't they?
Maybe. Oh, yeah, because look at this. I have notes which don't work anymore because they don't link to the browser anymore. Look at this. Notes full of memes for all occasions, which I love linking. Look, I've got a whole anti-goon. Whole anti-goon propaganda lot here. Funny 3 has basically just spawned from the World War B, and I'm not going to be able to use them anymore. Kind of makes me sad. But hey ho, that's the way.
That is a lot of links, man.
So I think that's pretty much all the Eve news covered. Is there any news you want to talk about on the Eve, on the Eve front, Nashh?
I'd say I'm really looking forward to CCP Falcon posting something on the Alliance tournament, which I guess we're all waiting for. And you know, I'm excited for that. I'm excited for watching some of the streams this weekend. And that's about it. Yeah.
I did have one thing, if you wouldn't mind.
Of course, you were actually going to be the next person I go to.
CCP Fox 4's last day was today.
Oh,
so just wanted to say thank you very much for his continued service over the years.
Yeah,
he's been like the main third party dude to go to for pretty much anything.
Yeah,
and obviously spawned the Sox 4 item that is now existing in game.
I remember getting that for the Christmas
great
one.
Amusement to the community. So wish him the best of luck in the future. I know he recently has also just been just proposed to his girlfriend, and he's
hey,
ooh, sucker.
Yeah.
No, no, Nashh.
Don't do it.
Don't be bitter. Don't be bitter. You know, be nice now.
I think she's
near me, so. Congratulations to him. Yes, he's heading back to Vancouver. Because his other half is heading back to study, so he's going back out there as well. But he's done some fantastic work at CCP. Without him, a lot of third-party developer stuff just wouldn't have happened, because beforehand it was just one dev kind of doing it in his spare time, and CCP Fox 4 really took it on upon himself, because he joined CCP, and I remember this one because I did an article about some of the API stuff that he did. He joined CCP originally not in a very technical role, and he took it upon himself to learn how the APIs work and develop them. And that's how that whole project got driven. And then we had the new launcher, which was responsible that, and now two years down the line from him doing that, we have the full Crest API integration, which is fantastic. It does amazing things, like I can use my phone to make a fit and save it, and it's in the game. You know,
that's pretty cool.
It does crazy things like that. It gives us a single sign-on. So he's done fantastic work. Now they literally have to have an entire team there to replace him and the work he did. So thanks a lot for all the work you've put into it, Fox 4, and good luck in your future endeavors. And I hope you won't be away from the CCP family for too long. So on that note, we're going to cut to our next video before we go on to our next segment, which is obviously all about Eve Valkyrie. Which is the bit you've been waiting for, General. So, we have this week, the Eve Valkyrie team released their latest update, which included the Carrier Assault map. Am I right in saying that?
Mode.
There we go. That's better. Which brings a whole new element of gameplay to the existing modes. Here's a quick trailer showing you what it's all about, and we'll be back straight after this.
We're at the battle site. Lots of useful tech still here. But it looks like a rival faction has turned up and they're not in a sharing mood. This time we need to do more than defeat the fighters. We need to take down the carrier. Capture the relays to bring down the carrier shields. Then take out the ship's core. Fighter wing away.
Good hunting. Roger. Hostile eliminated. Shields are down. Repeat, shields are down.
There we go. I'm so bad.
Wow.
I am so... Shall we rewind that whole conversation and start that again, shall we?
We
would have carried on for a while. So that was the trailer for the Valkyrie Carriage Assault. Tell us a bit about it and what's been going on with that, General.
So, Carrier Assault arrived on Monday as a new game mode for Eve Valkyrie. It's a mode rather than an actual map. You get to play the game type on all the existing maps plus one new one. The new map was shown to us at last FanFest as a bit of a preview. It hasn't changed since FanFest, it's exactly the same, which is called Crossroads. So the Carrier Assault is basically similar to the other game modes that you have. You have two Wyverns, mm-hmm. an enemy one and an allied one. They both arrive at the map. And using a method that already exists in the game, like a control mode, which is you take various points across the map, except in Carrier Assault, once you control two of three points across the map, you essentially deploy a virus, which brings down the shields on the enemy carrier, which allows the players to go and attack the enemy carrier. In the other game modes, when you kind of come into range of the enemy carrier, you get instantly destroyed. Whereas in Carrier Assault, once the shields are down, when you approach the enemy carrier, and there's actually incoming flak fire and incoming missile fire. So the carrier actually properly defends itself from multiple targets simultaneously, basically. It also has across it a series of cooling towers, which are kind of like hard points if you were to look at them. And players that are assaulting the carrier have to destroy these cooling towers in order to access the core on the carrier. Now the core is basically what you're constantly driving towards when you're playing to destroy. Once you destroyed it, it ends the game. You try and do a control match as quickly as you can. You get, I think, off the top of my head, it's a minute and a half worth of time once the shields are down to destroy as many of the control towers as you can, the cooling towers, to then be able to attack the core. Now, as I say, arrived on Monday, and a load of us were playing it on Monday, and one and I were discussing when we were playing it to see if it would be possible, for example, to actually play the game and get the shields, control points controlled, the shields down, the cooling towers removed, and the core destroyed in one cycle. So the game, if you don't do it in one cycle, there's no like apparent timer. There's kind of like a hidden timer, so you can do it so many times and then the game will just end. From what I've experienced, it's like around 5 control cycles and then the game will end. So if it goes the full length, it feels a lot longer than the existing game modes, which are 10 minutes long. But you obviously have the possibility of ending it very, very quickly if you do really well. So as I say, Juan and I discussed to see if it would be possible to actually try and get it all down and done in one. We did try a couple of times during the night, but it was actually surprisingly difficult. But luckily enough, we did try it again on Thursday night. It was myself, Juan, Vega, and Tally, who's also just got his Rift, and we gave it a go. Fortunately enough, and people can kind of argue it a bit, I guess, it was against entirely bots, so there was no human defense on it. But I mean, the bots are still relatively capable of controlling points across the map. They're just not the greatest, perhaps, at defending their carrier, as you'll notice here. But the carrier defense themselves still work absolutely fine, and it's still lethal. Previous game modes, I've played it and died horribly to the incoming flak fire.
Oh.
When you look at it, it looks seriously scary. So much so, so much flak ends up getting fired at you that I've even had it a couple of times where my headset's kind of freezed up as I've been playing because there's so much graphical stuff being shown. But hey, that's part of the game. it's part of the, like, the just sheer fear that it induces in you as you're playing.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, I've given yourself the video, so if you wouldn't mind just rolling it. This is one, myself, Tally, and Vega doing the carrier assault in a short amount of time, as you will see.
Fantastic. And we'll roll that right now.
Hey guys, General Stargazer here. As many of you know, Carrier Assault was introduced to Eve Valkyrie on Monday the 20th of June, and it's been absolutely fantastic. On launch night, 1-5 and I were playing a game and wondered if it would be possible to get the carrier destroyed in a single cycle of capturing points. And sure enough, on Thursday the 23rd of June, we managed to do it. We both recorded at the same time, so here's a short video showing both of our perspectives of the battle. Audio for the footage is from my own point of view, so my microphone is actually muted for the recording, but there are a few of us talking. Anyway, onto the video. Hope you enjoy it, and we'd love to see how quickly all of you can do it.
Are you streaming at the moment too?
This time we need to do more than defeat the fighters. We need to take down the carrier. This will have to
nice.
Be stages. Drain the relay stations.
If you ever do put this in stuff like this into a video,
then take
can you cut
ship's core.
My kill death ratio?
Our base ship at all costs.
Please. I don't care about kills, I care about control.
Control point C captured.
Sentry guns are operational. Avoid them on your approach.
I'll go lower.
Up to the bridge.
I'll poke things with sticks.
Get on it. Oh, I got pulled in. Yes.
Oh my God, what?
Quickest carrier death ever.
Severed the connection.
Granted, it was against all bots, but hell, they didn't see it coming.
Just that extra bit excessive.
Oh my god. One of these days I will get good. We will stop doing that. But, like what we were saying was, I mean, oh my god, that was pretty intense sort of stuff. It was crazy business.
It's absolutely insane. I mean, it's bad enough, as I say, with the flak. The incoming flak just kind of like, what is going on? But then you end up with alarms going off when your shields are dropped, and you're both concentrating on both trying to kill the core, and we both flew into the core at the end.
I love that bit. That was really funny.
Just concentrating so hard on trying to get the damn thing dead. I mean, and then when you come out, you both fly at the end, and we both turn around and we looked at the carrier. It's absolutely phenomenal to kind of see the thing explode. It's very rewarding in that aspect. I mean, I played it all week, and I'm not tired, and I don't think I'll ever get tired of seeing that thing explode.
I mean, the thing that I mean, that must be just so rewarding. Like, as you're flying away and this super carrier is just falling away into great big giant chunks.
Yeah, I mean, I even appreciate it even more because, I mean, the fact that I'm an EVE player and I'm playing Valkyrie as well, I know what the ship's like, and I know what happens in EVE when you blow up the ship just kind of, you get the pretty explosion, but it goes from a hull model to a destroyed model.
Yep.
Whereas obviously in Valkyrie you have that nice kind of transitioning, you've got these multiple explosions that's appeared down the ship as it explodes, and then as you say, it's broken into pieces. You get secondary explosions as well, and as you're flying through the ship, you can see the secondary explosions going off, more chunks fly off. It's so much fun to fly down.
I love it, it's good stuff. While I'm playing that, going through one of these Serpentis sites, I think I'm getting my butt kicked.
You do seem to have a lot of rats after you.
I know. They don't seem to be doing too much damage, which is also a pretty good thing. But I don't seem to be able to hit these frigates, which is a bad thing. Oh, I hit that one. But,
I mean, yeah. I mean, other Valkyrie news, there was a massive kind of rebalance to the support ships in the game.
Okay.
Previously, there was kind of like two realms of support ships. You had kind of fire support, which was support ships that were doing, they didn't heal anyone, they just did damage, but they did damage in particular ways. And then you had kind of support ships that did heal people. So you had your like medics in space.
Oh, nice.
But now they've been rebalanced to the aspect that each of the healing ones is very unique. So previously the healing ones were basically, they'd all heal, they'd all do damage, but they had different weapon systems, so they were doing different types of damage. Now, what was the healing beam has been changed on each of the ships, and one of them now regenerates shields faster, for example. One of them buffs your damage that you're dealing, one of them makes the target take more damage, one of them strips shields and adds it to your own. So they've kind of made the ships a lot more unique to play.
Okay, so they've given them a little bit more variety and a bit more choice on what you want to do for field team. Because a lot of the gameplay, from what I understand from watching your tutorials, it's very much you have a ship that counts as a particular ship, and you have to set up your team to work out in a particular way.
You do get that to a limited degree. I mean, how do I put this? There's not really direct counters, in my opinion. You have ships that synergize really well together. You can have a ship that does a lot of damage to shield and a ship that does a lot of damage to armor together, for example. So you can use the combination of the two ships to kill other ships really quickly.
Mm.
But then, obviously, you can't really counter something so much like that. You kind of end up having to use your environment a lot more to try and avoid the incoming damage being taken altogether. Or alternatively, you pick a ship and you try and kill them at range. There's lots of different, varieties of ship that, as I say, they don't necessarily directly counter each other so much as they work really well with other ships. The support ships themselves, you could pretty much, if you had a heal beam, you could pretty much put it with any other ship. Because its sole role was to keep its wingman alive, basically. And as long as it could perform that role, sticking with the friendly pilot, then happy days, basically.
Pretty much. And how's things going on with the Valkyrie scene at the moment?
So, I mean, in general, we've got a few updates on the Trello board. So, similar to kind of what Dust did, Eve Valkyrie actually has a Trello board that tracks things that are upcoming, things that are planned, things they like feedback on. We finally got the announcement this last week about the PlayStation VR launch date.
Yes.
And the Valkyrie will be launching on the PlayStation VR on October the 13th, I believe it is, off the top of my head. So that is something that we're all looking forward to. Beyond that, the other big announcement that we're kind of waiting on is when Vive support is coming along, which we have been told is will be this year. A few of us are hoping perhaps before PlayStation VR comes out that it will be supported, but we're kind of waiting for a date on that one. There's lots of things on the card for up and coming, really. In terms of developers as well, we've had one of the original Eve VR developers we found out is actually leaving the UK and the Newcastle team today.
Oh, Signa.
Siggy GG, as he is on Twitter.
Siggy GG, yeah.
CCP Karuk, I believe his name was. He is joining CCP Atlanta for a new exciting VR project, which I'm guessing is probably one of the ones that we've seen at FanFest. I don't think it will be anything new at this point. Which looks to be quite promising. I wish him all the best, and again, I met him at FanFest, which was pretty cool. And I'd be excited to see what actually comes out of Atlanta, really.
Yeah, because CCP have got a lot of really funky stuff going on. Oh, I've never seen that wallet pop up before. That's pretty cool. I like that. That's something new that's popped up. But yeah, I mean, the guys at CCP Atlanta seem to be working on real cutting-edge kind of VR stuff.
Yeah.
Basically laying all the groundwork for VR makers to design tools and build games with them. So I'm really interested to see what comes out of there. If you've never been to eFanFest, they quite often show offs. The Atlanta guys come and bring a whole demo setup. In 2015, they had like four or five booths in like one of the atrium areas of the Harper. This year, they had one of the big rooms all to themselves, because they were showing off that disc game that they had. Which is great fun, and I'm really, really keen to see what kind of happens with that. If you haven't seen that, I'd recommend going and checking that out. We might queue up a video for next month for that, and we'll kind of go from there. But if that's all the Eve Valkyrie news and wrapped up, I guess, maybe?
Yeah, I mean, that I can think of. I mean, we've obviously got the Eve Vegas sometime in the future as well, which we'll hopefully have a Valkyrie tournament at sometime in the near future as well. We're kind of trying to arrange for another EU versus US arrangement, but we have a lot of difficulty with it now. Previously, there was a relatively small amount of Valkyrie players, so getting a server that was completely empty was pretty easy. Whereas now there's been quite a few more rifts shipped, which has made kind of trying to find a quiet server a little bit more difficult. So we're hoping to speak to CCP to see if we can arrange something. Or alternatively, another thing that is on their Trello board, which they're planning to develop soon, which is tournaments and seasons. So maybe we might get something with that.
Which is something I'm very keen on finding out about.
I think a lot of us are. The game has a lot of potential in that regard. I think tournaments and seasons will be a big thing, especially once PlayStation VR and Vive support comes along as well as the crossplay between them. You'll have such a big audience of players that I think it will be something to really look forward to in the future.
I just like the captain's quarters, and it's really funky. It's like neon disco. Yeah, wait until you see my tune. That's a bit weird. Okay, we're going back to the ship hangar.
other than that, I think it's still waiting to be confirmed at the moment. Hopefully, at NT, we will have a small little Valkyrie tournament, which I think would technically be the next thing on the cards.
Maybe.
That is before Vegas. Yeah, it's before Vegas. So.
Yeah, because Vegas is in October 31st,
yep.
And EVE NT will be in September.
Yes. So, if that goes ahead, then that will be the next, I'm not going to say big Valkyrie tournament, it's going to be the next Valkyrie tournament.
Yep.
With potential for prizes. So, if you're not going to NT, please go to NT.
And on the subject of EVE NT, we have recently just updated our Patreon page. You can find it on event.co.uk.
Without the beer...
Without the beer might be a good time. I know exactly.
Yeah.
You can go to eve-nt.uk, scroll down to the bottom of the page, you'll see a list of our sponsors, but there'll also be a Twitter, Facebook, and a Patreon link. We have a Patreon page on there as well. We've also updated all the rewards for that, so that you can donate monthly, which will go towards the cost of your tickets for visiting Eve NT. So if you go and do that, that'd be fantastic.
Nice segue. However, just think of one thing that I did just completely miss altogether.
Got it.
Valkyrie has its first competition.
Wait, what?
Yes.
I don't know anything about this.
Well, that's why I'm here, you see.
So it takes two Stargazers to keep control of two universes. That's literally what it means.
We're covered. Between the two Stargazers, all the Eve, New Eden universe is covered. So, yes, Eve Valkyrie has its first contest. CCP Red Cape put it up on the forums this last week. Nothing overly exciting, I say, but it's for those that are imaginative, shall we go with. They have done a avatar competition. So the idea being is that you create a new icon, a new avatar for the forum.
Cool.
You put something together and you send it off to CCP Red Game. There is details up on the forum for like exact email addresses. The competition runs until the 15th of July. But the prizes, there's one of the nifty Eve Valkyrie controllers, which if you attended FanFest, you would have seen. It basically went one of the Xbox controllers, except it was branded specifically for Eve Valkyrie, so it's got a nice little Valkyrie logo and text on it. And there's also some Eve Valkyrie shirts, such as the ones that we've been giving away on our streams.
Nice.
And lastly, I think there's some signed Valkyrie artwork, which is quite cool as well. Make some avatars. Come up with different ideas. If you've visited the Valkyrie forums, you'll notice that everyone has... so if you're like a founder, you have a particular icon. And then there's a selection of, I think, four or maybe five different base icons, which change depending on what your level and rank is in the game. So they're just looking to kind of expand that. They can't promise that like the winners will have their avatars actually introduced to the game, because some might not actually suit the game. But they still might be amusing to look at or kind of share. But yes, go ahead. I don't even think you have to have. Let me have a quick read. Pilot name, real name. So yes, you do have to have a Valkyrie account. So you have to have pilot name, real name, contact number, and address to sent to redcape@ccpgames.com. Artwork must be in a 512 by 512 PNG format. Teamwork, you can enter as a team, but you obviously have to bear in mind that the rewards will be for a individual and you'll have to distribute it out. But yes, awesome artwork. Go, go.
Should be pretty good. Looking forward to that. Because if there's one thing that never ceases to amaze me is the creativity of the community as a whole, because they do some amazing work. They do some amazing work. I think I might actually be dying in this site.
Really?
Yeah.
Except before, you came out completely fine.
That is true.
Are you against? You're going against ships that you're flying.
I'm in a Proteus against Angel Cartel, but there we go. But I think that's all the Eve Valkyrie and the Eve Online news for this week.
I believe so.
So we're going to call it an end to the show at this point. Before we go, I would like to say happy birthday, Nashh Kadavr.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Nashh Kadavr.
Happy birthday to you. Fantastic. He is officially an old git. So next time you see him at EVNT, he's definitely an old git. He's older than me, which definitely makes him an old git.
Grey hairs yet?
Yes. He'd hate, don't ever like talk about to him about his hair. He will murder you for it. We'll call it to the end of the show for this evening. We nearly went on for 2 hours, which is pretty awesome. We have to finish us out for the evening. A couple of quick, one video, I should say. And that is Garma Speed Art, which is by the amazing Zach. He does a lot of work for the Eve community for trailers and stuff. Big Micah, for example, he does a lot of these trailers for the Furious series he does, and he's making, well, surprising enough, an Eve Garma. So check this out. Thank you very much for tuning in. We'll see you next week. I'll try and like wrangle some prizes out for Nashh next week for viewers, and we'll see you then. But otherwise, take care.
Adios.
Sweats, I'm all alone. Withdrawals from your love. If I could do it again, I'd rock with you. Yes, I would do it again. I'd rock, still rock with you. No, I can't get enough, I need some more. Give me some more. Tattoo your name with your tongue on my body. Thought makes me weaker, I don't wanna stop it. Can't get enough, I need some more. Can't get enough, give me some more. I'm lying all alone. You should be here to hold me. I just want you.
Stargazer.
Nulli Secunda, what happened to your Sov? Only the wallpapers are left. Test Alliance, Best Alliance,